Hello. Welcome to the session on PDCA. The variations of the PDCA cycle include Plan Do Study Act Cycle, also called PDSA Cycle, Deming Cycle, and Shewhart Cycle. The PDCA cycle enables an organization to ensure that its processes are adequately resourced and managed, and that opportunities for improvement are determined and acted on. The Plan Do Check Act cycle is a four-step model for carrying out change. Just as a circle has no end, the PDCA cycle should be repeated again and again for continual improvement. The PDCA cycle is considered a project planning tool. When should the PDCA cycle be used? Use the PDCA cycle when starting a new improvement project, developing a new or improved design of a process, product, or service, defining a repetitive work process, planning data collection and analysis in order to verify and prioritize problems or root causes, implementing any change, working toward continual improvement. What is the Plan Do Check Act procedure? At the plan stage, recognize an opportunity and plan a change. The planning stage is for mapping out what you are going to do to try to solve a problem or otherwise change a process. During this step, you will identify and analyze the problem or the opportunity for change, develop hypotheses for what the underlying issues or causes are, and decide on one hypothesis to test first. As you plan, consider these questions: what is the core problem we need to solve? Is this the right problem to work on? What information do we need to fully understand the problem and its root cause? Is it feasible to solve it? What resources do we need? What resources do we have? What are some viable solutions? What are the measures of success? How will the results from a small trial translate to a full-scale implementation? At the do stage, test the change. Carry out a small-scale study. The next step is to test your hypothesis, that is, your proposed solution. The PDCA cycle focuses on smaller, incremental changes that help improve processes with minimal disruption. Test your hypothesis with a small-scale project, preferably in a controlled environment, so you can evaluate the results without interrupting the rest of your operation. You might want to test the solution on one team or within a certain demographic. At the check stage, review the test, analyze the results, and identify what you've learned. Once you have completed your trial, it's time to review and analyze the results. This stage is important because it allows you to evaluate your solution and revise your plans as necessary. Did the plan actually work? If so, were there any hiccups in the process? What steps could be improved or need to be eliminated from future iterations? Your evaluation at this stage will guide your decisions in the next step, so it is important to consider your results carefully. And at the act stage, take action based on what you learned in the study or check step. Finally, it is time to act. If all went according to plan, you can now implement your tried and tested plan. This new process now becomes your baseline for future PDCA iterations. Consider these questions before you act. What resources do you need to implement the solution at a full scale? What training is needed for successful implementation and adoption? How can you measure and track the performance of the solution? What opportunities are there for improvement? What have we learned that can be applied to other projects? If the plan did not pan out as expected, you can cycle back to the planning stage to make adjustments and prepare for a new trial. The PDCA cycle is a particularly useful tool for companies that follow the Kaizen method. Kaizen is an organizational mindset and culture focused on small, frequent changes that lead to significant improvements over time. The PDCA cycle supports the Kaizen philosophy by providing the framework for developing and implementing continuous improvements. There will be a separate tutorial on Kaizen. If you like this tutorial, please share, like, and subscribe.